Hello everyone, welcome back to another new video, and today I will be showing you how to draw if you have tripled pawns in a pawn ending. In the following position, white is ahead in material but is actually on the verge of losing, because the three pawns on the b-file are all blocked by the pawn on b7, meaning that black is effectively the one ahead in material. Attempting move is pawn to b6, preventing king to c7 to gain some time for white. But this doesn't do much because black can act as if the pawn on the b-file doesn't exist and push the d-pawn. Even if white tries to keep the king away from the c-file, black can do a bit of triangulation with the king, forcing white to let black's king in with the king on d2, and after the b-pawns are all captured, black's last remaining pawn is enough to win. This means that white cannot waste time at all, and must start advancing the king immediately with the brilliant move king to g2. At first, this seems to just let black start capturing the pawns, but an accurate calculation shows that white will be just in time to reach d5 when black's king captures on b5, and after king takes b4, king takes d6, king takes b3, king to c6 wins the final pawn with a draw. Therefore, instead of king to b6, black goes for the same plan with king to d7 and e6. It seems that white's situation is hopeless. But this is actually an illusion because the tripled pawns have a very hidden ability in this situation, and that is, it can entirely prevent one's own king from moving in one direction if the king is standing next to it. See where this is going? Imagine a situation where white's b3 pawn is on b6, black's d-pawn and king is on d5 and e6, and white's king is on d4, white can actually play king to c5. And after king to e5 to save the pawn, it is a stalemate. Because it will take three moves for white to move the tripled pawns up one rank. If white has the move when the kings are on d4 and d6, white can just push the pawn and play king to c5 at the end, forcing a draw. With this in mind, it's easy to see that king to e4 will not work because after king to e6 king to d4 pawn to d5. White cannot play king to c5 after pushing the pawns, and playing king to c5 at any other moment will just let black's d-pawn promote. In addition, if black gets the king to e5, the game will also be lost because the stalemate trick no longer works if white can't get the king to c5. With this in mind, king to e3 also doesn't work as it will allow d5, and white cannot avoid getting the move when the kings are on d4 and e6. This leaves white with one final possibility, and that is the brilliantly counterintuitive king to f4, preventing d5 due to king to e5. After white is able to get the position with the kings on d4 and e6 with black to move, black makes one last attempt with b6, but this allows king to e3, again moving the king to the opposite colored square. After king to e5, king to d3, pawn to d4, king to c4 forces king to e4 if black doesn't want to lose the d-pawn, and it's just the same exact stalemate moved one rank down. Did you think it's going to be a stalemate from the start? If you want to see more brilliant chess tricks like this, be sure to like and subscribe for more, and I will see you all in my next video. Goodbye.